I've been a naturalist ever since first grade, when I was fascinated by snakes and other reptiles. When I was in high school in Savannah, Georgia, a friend from Boston, Richard Desrosiers, came to spend some months. He introduced me to amphibians and especially to frogs and toads. We found nearly all of these by hearing their calls and tracking them down, and of course, learned to identify them just by their calls. This pre-adapted me to birding by ear when I became enamored of these creatures later in life. You can see, for example, birds in Missouri on this YouTube channel.
Thank you.
Male frogs of most species produce advertisement calls, which attract females that are ready to mate, and which may repel other males. This may result in spacing in choruses or defense of a territory, in which females may lay their eggs after mating with the territory holder. Many species also produce aggressive calls, which often precede an attack on another male that has started calling in close proximity. Aggressive calls often sound like release calls, which males produce when another male tries to mate with them, or by females when they are not ready to mate. Normally separated by the different habitats where they breed, green and barking tree frogs may mismate and disturb habitats. The gray tree frogs, eastern and copes, cannot be reliably identified by their external appearance. The first species has what can be described as a melodic, slow trill, and the latter by a harsher sounding, fast trill. The American bullfrog defends territories in which females lay their eggs, with a high probability that he fertilized them. Females may well be assessing the quality of the territory, the male, or both. Early in the breeding season, males give many aggressive calls and engage in wrestling matches with other males. As the season progresses, aggression between pairs of males that have engaged in this behavior wanes, and usually only a few aggressive calls are produced. Evidence for individual recognition by calls was provided by playbacks of calls of an established neighbor versus those of a strange male. The latter greatly increased territorial responses to the speaker, aggressive calls, and even contact with the speaker. Further playback studies showed that the mechanism was habituation and that males mainly identified calls by the frequency spectrum. Yeah.
Ow. 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 Ow.